This is Match Game 74, production number 0168, air date to be announced, VTR 22374, and it's... take one. Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy. Brett Somers. Dick Gautier. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene River.
Lovable moods.
Yes, we are.
Oh. I hesitate to ask, but I guess I better, huh? Should I ask? Yes.
Yeah.
Well, you know, Bobby Van has been on this show, and he's married to this lady who's sitting in the first row here.
So
on
what?
The first seat in there, and she's got us one of his sweaters on, hasn't she? I think that's very charming and very loyal, and it's beautiful. Yes.
The word only fell off.
Listen, I wanted to point out to all of you who are here, if you haven't heard about it yet, Dick Gautier has a new record album.
Oh, you're not kidding. Thanks for mentioning it.
No, it's
called The Hexorcist.
The Hexorcist.
And it's weird. Gary Owens is on it, and J.P. Morgan and Pat Paulson.
I love J.P. Morgan.
So do I. No, we had a lot of fun, and it's crazy.
He says you can't play your record?
No, the hole in the middle keeps healing up.
Now let's say hello to our current champ, Kathleen Ellis, here. Hello, Kathleen. Kathleen has won one game. She's got $100 to her credit. And when time expired last time, she was about to go for the big ball of wax. over 5,000, or what are we calling? The big ball of aluminum foil.
I love you, Gene.
Guard.
I thought it was the big apple.
No, but she's going to try for over $5,000. Uh-huh. And are you ready for that, Kathleen?
Yes, I am.
Okay, it'll happen right after this message happens to you. All right, here we go with Kathleen Ellis, our current champ. She's got the $100. She's going to try for over $5,000. Now, you ready, Kathleen?
I think so.
Okay. You know how this goes. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. The last blank. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. The second most frequent response, $250. And if you match that third one, it's $100. A little help from the celebrities is allowed. Choose three, if you please.
Richard.
She chooses you, Richard.
Oh, yes. Well, I get a chance to plug Chicken Delight here. The Last Supper.
The Last Supper is Chicken Delight. Okay, there's one answer for you.
And
say goodnight, Gracie.
Yes. Ann Elder, what do you say?
I'll say The Last Tango in Paris.
The Last Tango in Paris, okay.
Dick.
The Last Mile.
The Last Mile.
A depressing thought, but nevertheless, that's it.
Yeah.
May I say something?
Yes.
I've written down The Last Goodbye, and I realized, wrong, it's The Long Goodbye.
Yes, wrong again. She's wrong when she's not even playing.
Let's beat her up.
Okay, so you've got The Last Mile, The Last Supper, and The Last Tango in Paris. Kathleen, you may choose one of those as your answer, or give us one of your own if you'd like right now, but we have to call for an answer now. What do you say?
The Last Supper.
She says The Last Supper. You think she's right? Well, we're hoping it's up there under the $500 thing for her, but we're going to find out if it is up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response. The Last Picture Show. Hey, that was a marvelous movie, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Really
Larry
terrific.
McMurtry.
But it gets you nothing. All right, we're still looking for The Last Supper. Here is the $250 response. Last Tango in Paris is up there. That's the one that Ann gave you. All right, that may be a good omen for you, Kathleen. Here we go, looking for the Last Supper. Here is the $500 response. So you've got that $500, and now it means you're up to $600. And now you're going to have a go at 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to collect that amount, you've got to match one celebrity head-to-head. It has to be an exact match. Please choose one now.
Richard?
She chooses you, Richard.
Present.
Okay. Now, you face me, if you would, please, Kathleen. I'll get the $5,000 question, and Richard will write his answer to this. Main blank. That's M-A-I-N blank. Okay, he's finished. Now, Kathleen, we need a response from you. How do you fill in that blank? Main?
Street.
You think she's right? Okay. She thinks she will match Richard Dawson by saying Main Street. So, Richard, for $5,000.
I don't understand. What is Main Street? I don't understand.
Main Street.
What is it?
It's a novel.
A Main Street.
Main Street. Every town in America has one. It was a famous novel.
Don't get nasty. I got it.
You're up to $5,600 now, and you're going to meet another player, and we'll start another game. How do you feel?
This is all.
All right, so let's welcome Jim Van Gundy. Hello, Jim. Jim, you know Kathleen Ellis? Kathleen's a little bit excited because she just won a lot of money.
Well, I can't say that I blame her. It's my turn.
How do you feel, Jim?
Oh,
wow. Really? Well, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I co-manage a jazz club here in town. I fly planes and into hang gliding now.
And you're into hand...
Hang.
Hang gliding. Oh, yeah. You mean gliding.
Right.
Oh, you know, that's well, fun. Like, where do you do that?
Out by Palmdale. They have a place down in El Segundo, but we go out by Palmdale.
Okay, well, good luck there, and good luck here too, Jim.
Thank you.
Continued good luck to you, Kathleen. Shall we begin, folks? I'll push the button, reveal two questions here, and ask our challenger to make a selection.
A.
A is what he gets, because that's what he wants. And here we go.
What you see is what you get.
Right.
Good thing Kathleen didn't call on me. I said Maine lobster.
Too late.
Glad, Kathleen. It's a...
Captain Hook lost his blank on the poop deck. Yes, he did. You gotta read more books, honey. Or you would have known about this.
Lost his blank on the poop deck.
Captain Hook lost his blank on the poop deck. First one finished up there.
First one.
Did you get that to
Kathleen? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's the winning card, Kathleen, that won you the $5,000 there. That'd be a good souvenir for you. All right, waiting for a couple of players here.
Oh, come on, Ann. Move it along.
Oh, I was just thinking about something.
I thought you were a writer.
We'll get a response from you now. Captain Hook lost his blank on the poop deck.
Oh, he lost his hook.
Then he wouldn't be Captain Hook anymore.
That's right.
Then he'd be Captain Blank.
Captain Blank lost his
Captain Blank lost his blank on the...
What do you say to that? He say he lost his hook.
I say he lost his hook. Exactly.
Yeah, there's a man. What did Captain Hook lose on the poop deck?
Oh, boy. Sometimes, you know, there were those days, and then there were those a whole lifetime.
Yes.
I said first mate.
Oh, really?
You don't have to do it so mean.
And they were so companionable, too. What did you say, Dick?
Well, those are both dumb answers. I don't care what they... Because he lost his scabbard.
He lost his scabbard?
A scabbard! You know what a scabbard is? A thing you put your hook in.
No, it's a thing you put your sword in.
Oh,
you don't know what a scabbard is.
I can get his hooks into you. Yeah.
What kind of answer came out of your pretty head?
Well, listen, you insulted me. You said I don't read and things like that. It's true, but he must not either because he lost his hook.
Oh!
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I didn't mean to insult you.
I know you didn't.
Oh. All right, Sir Richard.
What a nice title for a song.
What?
The Happy Hook.
I happen to know he lost his virtue.
Can you imagine anyone saying Captain Hook lost his virtue on the poop deck?
That is the silliest answer I really have ever seen. Ludicrous.
So, he lost his virtue twice on the poop deck. All right. So, Jim, you scored twice with that answer. We'll get to your half of the round in a moment or so. But first, we have a little business to do, and this is it, folks.
No, you're not hallucinating.
Here we go. Everybody ready? We'll finish the first round here with this question for Kathleen. Jim scored twice in his half of the round.
Anyone we know?
Oh, boy.
Maintain your face or this will be gone, you know.
Just as Prince Charming kissed Cinderella, the fairy godmother sneezed and turned him into a blank.
Say that again.
That was kind of a complicated one.
Yes, it was. I lost track.
Just as Prince Charming kissed Cinderella, the fairy godmother sneezed and turned him into a blank. All right. We're finished down to the lower tier, upper tier.
Cheer,
are you thinking about it? Okay, we'll get your response. Okay,
okay, we're all ready.
We're all ready. Now, Kathleen, just as Prince Charming kissed Cinderella, the fairy godmother sneezed and turned him into a...
frog.
Frog, she said. Turned him into a frog.
Read that question again.
No, I'm not going to read it again because you must have an answer by now.
And turn the prince into a princess, I said.
Into a princess, I see.
Oh, that's your autobiography, Bert. Okay.
Brett, what did you say about this?
Well, I'm so thrilled, I may just burst into tears.
She maxed you, Kathleen.
In all fairness, although she did match, that's her answer to the Captain Hook question.
Oh, I see. Dick, what did you say?
Well, being a Frenchman, of course, there is an anachronism for a Frenchman, which is a frog.
A frog. La grenouille, as they say. La grenouille, as we say in France. What did you say, my dear?
Well,
holy mackerel, I say is what I say.
The fairy godmother always wanted to relatives, so she turned him into a fairy.
Oh. Okay. Anything you say, sweet.
That's how I think.
Yep. Well, how do you think, sir?
Well, I don't think that makes you a bad person. I said El Frago.
El Frago. You're up to three now, Kathleen. So we had another El Frogger there.
Yes,
does she match you?
A little frog.
A frog! Yeah. Very good, Ann.
She did very well.
Okay. So in round one, the score is 4-2 in favor of our current champ, Kathleen. And now we go to round two. There it is. Jim, make a selection.
B.
He wants B this time. Last time, you matched Elaine and Bert, so the two of you will not participate. The rest of you will. Here we go.
Right.
Every day at noon, the Frankenstein monster goes to the park, gathers a whole bunch of pigeons together, and blanks them. That happens every day at noon.
And am I glad I don't have to write for that one?
When the sun is high in the sky.
All right.
I say when the moon comes over the mountain.
Oh, is that what you say?
When the moon comes over.
Thank you very much.
It's my imitation of Kurt Smith.
Are you ready down here?
Yeah.
All right, we're waiting.
Yes, I know.
Okay, now she's all set over there. And we will call on Jim for his response. Every day at noon, the Frankenstein monster goes to the park, gathers a whole bunch of pigeons together, and blanks them.
Cooks or bakes them.
Cooks or bakes them. Cooks or bakes them, he says. No, you're out of it.
I'm out of it.
Brett, are you
I've
in
been
it?
Out of
yes,
it for
you're
years.
In it.
Did you hear all those?
Yeah.
There are 500 Betty Whites out there. You're a smart little devil. Cooks.
Cooks.
There's one for you. There's a match. How about it, Mr. Gautier?
Knowing him intimately,
yes.
I would like to say that he eats them.
He eats them. I guess we can't match cooks or bakes with eats, but that was implied. How about you, Richard?
All right, I'll imply the same thing. Eats.
He eats them. Uh-oh, to stay in the game, Jim, you've got to match Ann Elder. What do you say, Ann?
Well, I was thinking that he was a little more of a monster. I said he defeathers them.
Defeathers them. So that does not match. Cooks and Kathleen wins another game. Congratulations. Thank you. There's another 5,700. Sorry it's been such a short visit with you, Jim. We'd like to get to know you a little bit better. We've got a gift for you backstage, together with our thanks for being on Match Game 74. Jim, thank you. We'll continue after this message for you. Don't go away.
Today's consolation prizes are Westclock's new Almanac Wall Clock, contemporary design clock with day and date feature that changes automatically. From Westclock's Italian Industries Company. And the Insinkerator hot water dispenser gives you 190 degree water at your kitchen sink like having a tea kettle always ready. From Insinkerator. And AstroTurf Doormats, a fresh new way to say welcome. Combines beauty, durability, and charm. AstroTurf Doormats for all seasons from Monsanto. And Profile with its own great flavor from a special formula of cracked wheat and wheat germ, just right for toast. Profile, it's a matter of taste. More blanks to fill our Match Game 74 in 1 minute.
Okay, here we go with Kathleen Ellis, who's now up to $5,700. She's going to have her second go at the big money super match here. You ready?
Ready.
Okay, we polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Blank high. You know how it goes? 500 for that one, 250 and 100, depending on which one you match. Three celebrities are allowed to help. Choose them one at a time.
Richard?
Richard, have you got a response for this? Blank high. Blank high.
Hollywood high.
Hollywood high. It's a local answer, folks.
Where's this lady from? Guam? You've heard of Hollywood High?
Hollywood high was the answer. Okay, that's his answer. Choose another one, if you please.
Hollywood low. I'll change it.
Dick Cody, have you got an answer?
I'm blank. I'm blanked. I blanked out on high. I'm high. I can't think of it.
All right,
time is up. Choose another one.
Ann.
Ann, have you got one?
Good high.
I don't know. Don't reveal the secrets of your private life on this show.
Well, it's an expression.
You got two rotten answers there you can choose from, Kathleen. Or give us one of your own. It's up to you now. No, I'm only kidding. Hollywood High and Good High are the two answers that you got from your celebrities. But we have to call for a response now.
Sky High.
She says Sky High. Sky High. Sky High is the answer she chose. She thought it up herself, and she thinks it's and hopes it's under the $500 response. We're going to find out right now, working our way up from the bottom. May we see the $100 response? 12 o'clock high, a name of a famous old motion picture there. That didn't occur to any of you.
That was great.
All right. Still looking for a Sky High. Here's the $250 response. Knee high.
To a grasshopper.
Yes. Yeah. Surprise. You didn't think of that, Mr. Fields. Okay, last chance for Sky High. Here is the $500 response.
And that's fine.
This Dawson, we're going to have to take the bottle of booze away from you. Unless you can do better than that.
The guy that operates that thing is a little too hard.
Congratulations to you. You've got the $500. That means you're going to be playing for 10 times that amount again, or $5,000. Remember, you got to match one celebrity to collect head-to-head. Must be exact. Here we go. Please choose one.
It's got to be Richard.
It's got to be Richard.
Well, when you give Hollywood highs, you expect to be chosen.
That's right. Right, you face me if you please. And I'll get the $5,000 question, Richard. Here it is. Old blank. Old blank. O-L-D. He's finished. Now we need a response from you. How do you fill in that blank? Old?
All I can think of is old man in the shoe.
Old man in the shoe?
It's old lady.
It was an old lady in the shoe, wasn't it? Who had the one with all the kids?
Too late now.
I mean, how could the old man in the shoe have all those kids? Well, I mean, he was there alone. Well, anyway. We have to accept that as her answer. Judge, is that it? Old man in the shoe, is that her answer? Okay. I hope you've written that, Richard.
No, I did, but I threw it
old
away.
Old man in the shoe. We have to show and tell now.
Yeah, well, I really don't feel so bad because you... I have to be an amnesia victim to match it. I said Auld Lang Syne.
Auld Lang Syne. Very good answer.
Who lived also in a shoe.
Yes. Okay, so well, songs. Kathleen, the winnings here put you up to $6,200. You're still a champ. We're going to meet another player. But first, we've got a message for you, and this is it.
GSN presents Behind the Blank. Growing up, this radio DJ was a huge fan of the Match Game. Was it Rick Dees, Ryan Seacrest, Howard Stern, or Carson Daly? Stay tuned for the answer. You know which radio DJ was a big fan of Match Game? The correct answer is C, Howard Stern. Gene was flattered and in turn looked up to Howard. Not because Gene admired Howard's show, but because Howard was at least 6 inches taller. Stay tuned for more of that 70s hour on GSN.
Sorry to say our time is up for today. I hope you'll be able to join us next time. I hope you'll stay tuned now to see old Bert Convy there with his show Tattletales. It's a lot of fun.
That's what I said.
Gene Rayburn.
Old Bert Convy.
Never mind. Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.